the Carl Garret mortar. It was a massive 124-ton mortar, of which 7 would be built during World War II. Today, there's only one remaining on display in Russia. Ultimately, this siege mortar was one of many overly ambitious German designs, lending itself to many modern, wacky appearances in pop culture and video games. But it did have some actual combat use. In 1936, Germany began planning for a potential war with France, which meant having to deal with the Maginot Line, an incredible fortified trench and fortress system that spanned much of eastern France. One solution to defeating this defensive line was simply to enlarge siege weapons, which is why the Carl Garret was developed. The Carl Garret became one of the largest guns of World War II in caliber, second in Germany only to the 800mm Gustav railway guns. The mortars had a caliber larger than the guns of the Yamato battleship. However, the siege of France would not happen. The German army decided it would be much easier to invade France simply by going around the Maginot Line through the Ardennes and Belgium. But the guns would still be built, and 7 were complete between 1940 and 1942, and despite being incredibly challenging to transport, they were used with mixed results in several battles. This included attacking the Soviet fortresses at Brest and Sevastopol, and most infamously, against the city of Warsaw. The massive guns first saw action in May of 1941, shelling Soviet border fortifications near Lviv. In February of 1942, Thor and Odin, that's the guns, participated in the siege of Sevastopol, where they were able to damage several fortified turrets. But these guns were a technical and logistical pain. Combat issues included assembly problems and the use of non-standard ammunition, which could cause rounds to get stuck or not fire. Between August and late September of 1944, 4 separate Carl Garret mortars would be used on the city of Warsaw against the Polish resistance. The mortar shattered whole buildings. However, the damage was mitigated as many of the shells were designed to be used against hard fortified targets, such as bunkers, and many didn't explode on Warsaw's soft ground. Ironically, it was reported that Polish sappers even salvaged explosives from the shells to be used against the German army. The Carl mortar weighed an incredible 124 tons, about the weight of 4 Sherman tanks. Despite this, it was self-propelled and had a top speed of 10 kilometers an hour, with a maximum range of 60 kilometers. However, propulsion was largely used for aiming. The heaviest munition at 60 centimeters diameter weighed 2,170 kilograms. Its lightest shell weighed 1,250 kilograms, which had the greatest range, at just over 10 kilometers. Lighter shells were fired from 3 of the mortars converted to a smaller 540mm caliber barrel. The shells flew slowly through the air, and the weapon was by no means meant to take on mobile armor. The mortars were transported by rail in a complex process requiring significant manpower, which was the biggest downfall of the gun. Assembling the gun took hours. Each gun needed a minimum of 21 crew. Modified Panzer IVs had to be used as support vehicles, each only able to carry a maximum of 4 shells. Special forces were typically assigned to further protect the weapon. Positioning the gun for firing was a complex task. It required hard soil. On soft soil, it could easily throw a track. Its firing position often needed preparation and leveling. Once ready to fire, the mortar could only be loaded at zero elevation, so it had to be re-aimed between every shot. The mount could traverse 4 degrees on each side independently of using the tracks. In the last year of the war, Carl mortars attempted to slow the Western Allies, but were unable to redeploy quickly enough to be of any help, and failed to destroy any bridges. In the East, it can be easily said the Carl mortar did more to divert needed resources than it did to aid in any battle, or even boost morale for troops, who'd come to need supply trucks and winter clothes over giant artillery shells. Alright, I'm Johnny. Thanks for watching this little video on this giant mortar. I hope you have a nice rest of your day, and we'll see you next time.